paying his rent, right? Look, it's not your responsibility to keep him afloat. I'm just saying, if Greg got off his ass and got a job...
He's working on his supply for stuff.
Why can't you just pick a nice guy? For once.
Greg is very nice.
Greg is very pretty.
What's on Travis back there?
I looked at Travis. I'm married.
Greg is going to get a job. He's actually in an interview right now.
I told him to leave.
High ankle sprain. That's day surgery.
Let's get back to your breakdown.
How on earth is that relevant?
Maybe it is, maybe it's not.
Okay, that is more competition.
We can go around in circles all day, but I'm the only one who can sign off on your discharge.
For a fucking sprained ankle?
No specific question. I just thought it must have been really hard to find your boyfriend with another woman.
Yeah. Yes, it was.
So how did you respond after breaking up with her?
I don't know, I dealt with it. I had a drink, went for a run, got on with my life. I threw myself into my work.
So, the woman in Arkansas died. But hey, she had a good life. Lawyers have released us from all responsibility. So, you know, power dawn it is. Same product, beautiful new packaging, copy, testimonials, everything. Any questions? Andy.
Oh, it's Andy.
Oh, sorry. I had a girlfriend in high school. Yeah, you look a bit like
I actually had a question about bullets.
How you talking?
You know, I know we're not there yet, but I need to think about some of our marketing angles.
Yes, absolutely. When we get to the email campaign, I really want to nail that grandparent demographic.
Right, exactly. So, this is going to sound a bit outside of our comfort zone, but I think that we could make a social media play. Facebook hasn't pulled their spam the same way that email has, so someone could see an ad for a supplement and it's targeted specifically towards them. They might not even think of it as advertising. The stats are surprisingly encouraging.
Direct mail and email has always been our honeypot with these older folks in it. Hey, my grandfather's 90 and he's on Instagram. I mean, he has no clue how it works, but that's how he sees pictures of his friends. I love that.
That's a really great example. Now, Instagram doesn't have quite the same penetration in the 75 plus demo as Facebook.
Instagram, Facebook, whatever. The point is, we can reach people this way, right?
Yes, sir, we can.
Great, let's do it. Annie, I want you to have a point on this. As long as it doesn't interfere with PowerPoint.
No.
dating again? Why is that funny?
You married?
I am.
How about you?
36 years next month. You're right.
It's not good for you guys because it's my field out there. I gained like 10 pounds in 3 days.
Well, right in Rome, literally.
So have you ever been?
No, I wish. But there is this gelato place in Lexington, Dolce Nuova.
Yes.
Do you know it?
I work like 3 blocks from there. I tried really hard every day to not go to that place.
Excuse me, I'm just gonna run to the restroom.
Okay. I'll just be here. Punctuation is a thing for me, so a guy who knows how to use his possessive apostrophes and his semicolons correctly is a huge turn on. I thought he'd try and change my luck, so I didn't bother with the first date drinks at the bar, movie, told my friends where we were going, drove separately.
I've never seen Touch of Evil. Did you enjoy it?
Sort of. Thank you. leather pouch.
That wasn't me.
No, I know, it's just my stupid cat.
You laughing at me is not awesome.
I know, I'm not laughing at you. It's the couch, I promise. For a first time, it was actually pretty good. I couldn't afford a new couch, so the next day I bought some blankets, multiple stuff. What's going on out there?
Red tape.
How did you get that bruise on your head?
What?
You have a bruise on your head. Do you remember how you got it? Sprained ankle.
Don't.
I sprained an ankle. The reason I'm here. Come on, we talked about this. I came in for minor surgery on an ankle sprain, and then you came in here and jumped up my ass about all this stuff that I can't remember.
I remember a conversation. I don't remember anything about a sprained ankle.
For God's sake. No. That's not right, because I came in for surgery for an ankle sprain. Let's see. Have I had this the whole time?
It's not unusual to have memory loss or confusion when one has suffered a traumatic injury.
Sprained ankle, broken fibula, some sort of thing, right? It's probably one of those painkillers. As opposed to, you know, losing my mind.
What was it like to be dating?
Yeah, it was great. I really liked him. Tom was kind of like a flavor enhancer. Just made everything even better.
And so I finished up my finance degree at OSU, your Buckeyes, and then took a job out here. I must be doing something right because they keep promoting me.
What's your living situation?
I am loft at the mainland.
How many bedrooms?
Two.
Any previous marriages? Kids we should know about?
No previous marriages and no kids, but I am the fun uncle.
You're a funkle? Alright, and I like this one. Is he a good kisser?
Yeah, right.
Yes. Oh, wait, show them the resort.
Resort?
Yeah.
my teen years on and off, in and out of moon boots.
Sounds like you need Prolig. Oh, is that your new supplement? Yes. And guess who's writing the copy? Stop.
Really?
I made some great suggestions a while back, and my boss said I could run with it, so.
That's amazing. Yeah. I'm so proud of you, Rachel. Your trays are on the way out. Kitchen, can I get everybody another round?
Yeah, let's get another bottle. And it's nice on me.
That's very nice. He's a keeper.
So, can I get this mural?
Well, to be honest, you're not really in our target demographic. I don't have any grandparents with sorrows. Well, it's not guaranteed to do it.
It doesn't work well.
Oh, yeah, it doesn't not work. It will make your joints
work.
And actually, according to research, 61% of people did experience some joint relief.
Come on, 61%?
It's not actual clinical testing. It's not like the bare minimum they have to do to say they tested it. So most users may have only manifested an improvement. Imagine they felt better. It's a whole thing. Anyway, whatever. It's a job.
It's a job.
So hey, cheers. New love. Oh boy. And to hold
staring at me.
Yeah.
You like the way I wash dishes?
I kind of like everything you do.
Buddies. What is that?
It's kind of like Scrabble, but with subtle differences to avoid copyright issues.
Oh, you playing against someone?
Yeah, Alan G77.
Alan?
I don't know, the game assigns people randomly, but he's good. Only up by 2 points.
Can I see?
Hmm?
Yeah, let me see. Jesus, how do you use this thing?
Squint mostly?
I know a great screen repair guy. He gets another one for $100.
Thank you, but I can't really afford that.
Forget it. Okay. This is easy.
Mall?
6 points.
Yeah, but there's a triple word score that I was trying to use. Ugh, of course you just typed it.
Okay. Find a better word.
It's okay, I can do it.
Cool. Do it together. How about
style? guys just use each other's phones?
Yeah, of course. I just want to cut.
Oh. Cut or uncut? I need to know these things.
The buzz is fucking building, people. I'm telling you. The focus groups were great. And the bean counters found an extra $40,000 for the social media strategy. Now, let's talk color schemes.
Actually, Mr. McKay, I have a copy suggestion I wanted to share with the group. So I was thinking of opening with sick of joint pain, but I think now I'm actually going to go with tired of joint pain, because we're not claiming to cure sickness. We are simply offering an alternative to being weighed down by the chronic aches and pains that folks at this age suffer from every day. It's a tiny shift, but I think it will subtly change how people read it.
Hey, if it sells more pills. John, what do you think?
That could work.
Great, incorporate it into the copy. You got it. Anything else? Okay, great.
Wait, sir, I thought I was writing the copy.
You did. You're the copy editor, yeah. You got the copy. And you're great.
Sir, you told me to run point on it.
I meant the research. You know all that Facebook stuff you were talking about? You did that.
Yeah.
And Sean, you've been working on the copy.
Six.
Right?
Out.
Yeah.
Six out.
Make the exchange.
Seven.
Good team. Yes. Good team. Where were we?
Psychological reason for that?
Maybe.
You were in a new relationship. Doubts started to creep in about it, about the two of you.
Right. Do you make a good living at your job?
I can pay my bills.
Easily?
I mean, no, not easily.
An opportunity for advancement at your work doesn't pan out, but you've met this new fella who's very generous with his money. Maybe you felt a little trapped.
I wasn't trapped. I really liked Tom.
At your job then, you felt your work wasn't respected, but you couldn't quit because you needed the money.
No, I've quit jobs before. I always land on my feet.
On your feet? Anything you want. Or nothing at all.
Yeah, let's do that. Nothing at all.
Okay. We'll pick this up tomorrow. Good night.
Thank you. What do you smell?
I can't really tell. Cleaning stuff that you smell. Was trying to screw things up with time.
One, two,
three. Okay, alright. Two hands.
Okay, so.
One, two, three.
things can be a bit tired for you sometimes. Cheers.
That was very nice of you. Are you almost done?
Not really.
Oh. Well, do you want to watch some TV?
This is important.
Six.
Right.
Seven.
To talk about last night.
Thank you.
that's a little strange, don't you think?
What?
How it all became about him.
Well, he was really stressed at work.
So that means you deserved what you did to you?
No, but I was being a bit of a bitch, and I was trying to provoke her.
Tom walked in here right now, and you could get right up into his face and call him every name under the sun. And if he laid a finger on you, it would still be 100% wrong. We do see that, don't we? And even if he didn't play a finger, disrespecting you, disrespecting your work, making you feel unimportant, that's abuse. How much worse did it get?
Direct mail ready to drop, and we even bought ads to hit the seniors on Right Wing Radio. This is gonna be fucking huge. Highest awareness numbers we've ever seen on the track.
Also the highest number of disclaimers we've ever put out.
Come again?
Disclaimers? This statement has not been approved by the FDA. Results can and will vary.
Yeah, but that's the beauty of it. They get lost in the boilerplate while my granny goes online to see the pictures of her grandson's graduation, and she feels that ache in her hip. Boom! Tornig is right there to cure it.
But it won't cure it.
Where's this coming from? I thought you were a team player.
Mr. McKay, I know that we're not curing cancer here, but we don't need to deceive people. We actually have an opportunity to be different, to apply a little bit of honesty.
Shoot.
Sense of happiness on other people. It's too much pressure.
He was better than nothing.
You're not nothing. And look at me. Tell me you believe that. Okay, let's take a break. Actually, I should check people are doing day in the cafeteria.
You still haven't told me why I'm here.
You're going to tell me. You're going to say that. Actually, I just wrote to the judge asking for an extension on the cycle.
I just spoke to your boss. And can you please regret Sam?
Wait. I realize you're under a lot of pressure to close this case. I get that. But if you come at her with everything all at once, she'll just decompensate. She'll shut down. We could figure out the game plan together. Detective Anderson is going to show yourself up to brass. If you feel in any way uncomfortable, we'll stop. Okay?
Okay. Thank you.
of the stuff. She just replaced the repressed memories with invented ones.
Maybe there's just a little bit.
What's she doing?
What?
You're siding with Olsen.
I'm not siding with him. I'm just trying to think about what might work.
I don't need you to think about anything. In case it slipped your memory, I've been doing this a long fucking time. In English, there's no verb for truth. You can be honest or tell the truth or be truthful, but you can't truth. Maybe it's so rare it wasn't worth coining a verb for. But there are so many ways to lie, to distort. You're the language expert, you know all the limits. Do you know what the biggest lie you tell yourself is?
I should have been running at night.
You can run whenever you want. Why were you? You're on